Hello students, welcome to IBPS Guide YouTube channel. Today we will discuss some comprehensions which consist 10 questions for LICAO exams as well as SBI PO prelims exams. As you know, comprehension is an essential part of your competitive exams. So that's why today our topic is comprehension, and it is little bit of large comprehension, and we just learn how to crack the comprehensions and how you can use, you can solve easily all of your questions. Let's move to question number one. At first we read the direction. Here the direction is question number 1 to 10. Go through the given paragraphs and answer paragraphs related questions. Here is paragraph 1, paragraph 2, paragraph 3, and our next slides we will get paragraph 4, paragraph 5 and paragraph 6. So this comprehensions consists 6 paragraphs and 10 questions. So let's go through the paragraph. Which is the topic of this paragraph? At first we have to aware about that, then we can solve the questions. The pedestrians accounted for over half of fatalities in road accidents on the city streets in 2018. A study by Bloomberg Philanthropist Initiative for Global Road Safety, that is BIGRS, in collaboration with the Mumbai Traffic Police has found. The key findings of the study were discussed at a press interaction organized by BIGRS in Mumbai on Thursday afternoon. The study states that 51% of the victims who died in road accidents last year were pedestrians. The study further states that a majority of these victims used the roads to work owing to lack of proper footpath. So in our first paragraph, if we run through the preview of this paragraph, that is the pedestrians accounted for over half of fatalities in road accidents on the city streets in 2018. So the survey of 2018, where we see that pedestrian accounted for over half the fatalities in road accidents. So the road accident, the major portion of fatalities due to that, these are the pedestrian in 2018. This is a study of Bloomberg Philanthropist Initiative for Global Road Safety, that is BIGRS, in collaboration with the Mumbai Traffic Police has found. The key findings of the study were discussed at the press interaction organized by BIGRS in Mumbai on Thursday afternoon. The study stated that 51% of victims who died in road accidents last year were pedestrian. So the main preview of the paragraph 1, that is a pedestrian who are victims of road accident. And in paragraph 2, Kelly Larson, director Bloomberg Philanthropies, said a number of road accidents number of road accident deaths peaked at 611 in 2015 has dropped down 475 in 2018, and there is a decline in the road crash injuries from 4029 in 2015 to 3292 in 2018. Males and females accounted for 85% and 15% of fatalities respectively, and the pattern that has been consistent with the previous years. This information suggests not just about the presence of the number of male and female on the road, but also their uses of the road. In paragraph 2, Kelly Larson, director Bloomberg Philanthropist, he explained some reason, and he gave some data also, which is a number of road accidents, death peaked, what is the number of death peaks, and which is the percentage of males and females and pedestrians, etc. So it is clear to us this paragraph will be consist of road accidents and their data and their analysis. What is the reason of road accidents, and what is the number of people are victims in road accident, and what is the consequence. So it is clear to us the motive location elimination, if we apply this method, motive location and elimination, this the motive of this paragraph is road accident. Okay. So at first we have to go through the first question. Referring to paragraph 1, here also, here it is already mentioned. Referring to paragraph 1, what does the study of Bloomberg Philanthropies, an initiative for global road safety, that is BIGRS, state? What does a study at Bloomberg Philanthropies initiative for global road safety, BIGRS, state? So answer will be in paragraph number 1. It is clear to us because here already mentioned it referring to paragraph number 1. So just we have to go through the paragraph 1 and we easily get our answer. So question is, what does the study at Bloomberg Philanthropist Initiative for Global Road Safety? What does the study? First option, Bloomberg Philanthropist Initiative Global Road Safety BIGRS stated that 51% of the people who died in road accidents were pedestrian. That is our first option. The second option is, the driver couldn't wait for the signal and to go green during the rush hours. Third option, there is a lack of proper footpaths which acted as a major catalyst in these accidents. So which can be the correct option? First option to definitely correct, because here it is mentioned the study states at 51% of the victims who died in road accident last year were pedestrian. It's given here. And second option, the driver couldn't wait the signal to go green during the rush hour. This is not the mentioned information, so it will be not our answer. And third option, there were a lack of proper footpaths which acted as a major catalyst in these accident. This is also given here. The study further said that the majority these victims used to roads work on wing, lack of proper footpath. So guys, it is clear to us, first option and third option, 1 and 3 will be our answer. So that's why option B will be our answer, 1 and 3, because these two information are, these two information, pieces of information is given in this paragraph. So that's why 51% of victim and lack of proper footpath. So first question, the answer will be, answer of the first question is option B. Let's move to question number 2. Question number 2, according to passage 2, here already mentioned this, according to passage 2, that's mean the answer of these questions will be in paragraph number 2. According to passage 2, what does Kelly Larson say about lives lost in road accident? Kelly Larson, director Bloomberg Philanthropist, what is his opinion about the lives lost of the road accident? Here first option is, the road accident peaked to 611 in 2015 and dropped down 475 after 3 years. This is a given information. The number of road accident death peaked at 611 in 2015 and has dropped down 475 after 3 years. Second option is, males accounted for 15%. Here is given, males and females accounted for 85% and 15%. That's mean 85% is related to male. But here it is mentioned that males accounted for 15%. So it will be not the correct option. This information is not correct here. And children were most vulnerable to these road accident. This is not mentioned here. Children were most vulnerable to these road accident. Here it is not mentioned. So that's why second option and third option will not correct. It's the correct option will be only 1. So our answer will be B. You can easily match the information with the paragraph. So you get your answer. Let's move to question number 3. Question number 3, whom does Kelly Larson give credit to for the decline of the number of road fatalities since 2015 as in paragraph number 3? So that's mean answer is given in paragraph number 3. Whom does Kelly Larson give credit to for the decline in the number of road fatalities since 2015 as in paragraph 3? Let's read the paragraph number 3. The largest proportion that lost lives in road accident in 2018 were of young men between the age of 20 and 29. Mr. Larson said that the road fatalities have decreased by 22% since 2015 owing to sustained efforts by BIGRS and Mumbai Traffic Police. We have taken efforts through this joint initiative to better overall road safety in the city, and we hope to witness as improved situation in the year come, Joint Commissioner of Police Traffic Amitesh Kumar said. Let's move to option. First option is, joint effort of BIGRS and Mumbai Traffic Police is a reason why road fatalities have come down since 2015. This is a given information. Option A. And the second option is the pedestrian have become more aware about aware and taking conscious effort to avoid the road fatalities. And option three is BIGRS has made huge contribution bring mass awareness of among people. So which can be the correct option? The information matched here only one. Second information and third information and is not given here, so that's why second and third will not our answer. Our answer will be only first, so that's why it will be C. Option C will be answer. Let's move to question number 4. Question number 4, in our next slide we get another 3 paragraph, paragraph number 4, paragraph number 5, paragraph number 6. At first run through the paragraph. Paragraph 4, the initiative included the placings, the initiative included placing enhanced focus on policing through closed circuit television, that is CCTV cameras, for better monitoring of traffic and the stricter enforcement of traffic rules. Over the last 2 years, the city police have been empowered to take action against traffic rule violation. High-tech measures like installation of speed cameras and the e-challan system have also provided a much needed shot in the arm of police efforts. These all are the efforts. CCTV, closed circuit television, speed cameras, e-challan, these all are effort to declining the road accident. And paragraph number 5, in the last 5 years, emphasis was laid on creating refuge islands for ease while crossing the junction and the tightening corner areas to ensure the cars reduce their speed while turning. Speaking at the press interaction, Sarah Whiten, Vital Strategies USA, quoted Michael Bloomberg, founder the Bloomberg Philanthropist. She said, "If you can't measure it, you can't manage it." These all are the suggestion. And Brett Herman, paragraph number C, paragraph 6, Brett Herman, senior road policing advisor, Global Road Safety, said that there is no silver bullet solution. There is no silver bullet solution, and the related issues and the combination of solution, right from collecting data, running media campaigning, have to be explored. And Dhawal Asar, manager, Integrated Transport World Resource Institutes India, said, while designing and redesigning the existing streets, factors that need to be considered and include the continuity of footpath and wide the footpath. Means 4, 5, 6 paragraph is related to consequence, suggestions and remedy to control the road accident. Let's go to question number 4. In our question number 4, according to passage 4, that's been question number, the answer of the answer of question 4 will be given in paragraph number 4. So according to passage number 4, what are the initiatives taken by them to curb road accident? What will be the initiative? What are the initiatives to curb road accident? And it will be, and the answer will be given in passage number 4. Okay, the first option we get, installation speed cameras and e-challan system, which is given here, installation of closed circuit CCTV camera and speed cameras and e-challan system. Speed cameras and e-challan system, this is given here. Close monitoring roads close to, this is also given here. Closed circuit television, and the city police have been empowered to take against actions in traffic rule violations, that is also given here. Much needed shot in the arm of the police effort. So that's why, and most important, the city is police empowered to take in against traffic rule violation. So all information is given here. That's why our answer will be all of the above. That will be E. And clearly all the options are mentioned to curb the road fatalities. These all options are mentioned. Let's move to question number 5th. Question number 5th, what does Michael Bloomberg said about conducting road safety related intervention in paragraph number 5? Again, answer will be given in paragraph number 5. What is saying Michael Bloomberg say about conducting the road safety Okay, so first option, there is no need to conduct any kind of survey to conduct road safety related intervention. Second option, she emphasized on tracking the number of accident related deaths and injuries in order to conduct road safety related interventions. And third option, she emphasized on bringing awareness among the pedestrian to curb road menace. We have to look forward the which will be the correct option and which answer, which options is given in paragraph number 5. In paragraph number 5, in the last 5 years, emphasized were laid, create refuge island for ease while crossing at junctions and tightening corner areas to ensure the cars reduce their speed while turning. So, which can be the correct option? First option, there is no need to conduct any kind of survey and conduct road safety related intervention. That is absolutely not the correct option. Guys, I hope it is clear to you. Where we just a paragraph is based on declining of road safety. So here it is a mentioned, this is that there is no need to conduct any kind of survey to conduct road safety related intervention. This will be not the correct option. Second option, she emphasized on tracking the number of accident related death and injuries ordered to conduct the road safety and related intervention. Definitely it will be correct option. She emphasized, and it is mentioned also here, she may emphasize the importance of tracking the number of road accident related deaths and injuries in order to conduct road safety related intervention. This is given information. And third, she emphasized on bringing awareness among the pedestrian to curb road menace. It is not given here, so that's why our answer will be second. She emphasized on tracking the number of accident related deaths and injuries in order to conduct road safety related intervention. Option second will be the correct option, so that's why C will be our answer. Okay, C and here A is also mentioned, so no problem, you can write A also, you can write C. B means option number 2 will be the correct option. Okay, let's move to question number 6. In the last 5 years, what was obligatory changes done in order to ensure the road safety as in paragraph number 5? In last 5 years, it is given in paragraph number 5, in last 5 years, what were the changes in order to ensure road safety? What will be the changes in paragraph number 5? The first option is refuge islands were created for ease while crossing at junction. This is given option. We get this answer also, we get this line also. In our first line, the refuge, creating the refuge island for ease while crossing at junction and tightening corner areas to ensure that cars reduce their speed while turning. And tightening corners ensured, this is also given. And overbridge were built to ensure pedestrians don't cross the peak hour. Overbridge, this is not given in information here. Overbridges were built on, this is not a given option, so that's why 1 and 2 will be the correct option. 1 and 2 will be the correct option, that's mean our answer will be A, that is 1 and 2. Let's move to question number 7. What does Brett Herman say about road safety according to paragraph number 6? This is paragraph number 6, and what does Brett Herman say about road safety according to paragraph number 6? What is the opinion of Brett Herman? First option, he suggested exploring options like collecting data about road accident. Here it is given or not. Brett Herman, senior road policing advisor, Global Road Safety, said that there is no silver bullet solution to the road safety related issue, and combination of the solution right from collecting data. That is given information, collecting data of running media campaigns have to be explored. First option. And the second is here, he suggested exploring options like running media campaigning. This is also given option, one in one line, campaigning over. And third option, he wanted to citizen to do car pooling twice a week. It's not given here. So that's why 1 and 2 will be the correct option. So our answer will be B, first and second. Because both information is given here related to issue, combination of the solution right from collecting data to running media campaigns have to be explored. Let's move to question number 8. According to paragraph number 6, what factors does Dhawal Asar mentioned about designing existing streets? Dhawal Asar, the manager integrated transport, what did he say? What did he say about the designing existing streets? So the WLSR manager, Integrated Transport World Resource Institute India, said, while designing and redesigning the existing streets, factor that need to be considered include the continuity of footpath, the width of the footpath and conducive condition of the pedestrian to walk of the footpath. So first option, factors like continuity of footpath have to be considered. It is not a first option. The factors like continuity of footpath have to be considered, which this is correct information, because the factors need to consider include the continuity of footpath. This is given here, continuity of footpath is given here. So first option is correct. Second, residential area should be away from busy street. This is not given information, so it will be not our answer. And factors like width of footpath have to be considered. It's also given here, the conducive condition of the condition pedestrian in the work and width of footpath. So option one and option three, one and three will be the correct option. So that's why our answer will be D, first and third. Next question number 9, paragraph number 4. Over the last 2 years, the city police have been empowered to take action against traffic rule violation. How is the city police has been empowered to take actions against traffic rule violation? Paragraph number 4. This is paragraph number 4. Answer will be given in paragraph number 4, and here it is paragraph number 4. So which can be our answer? First option, the city police have been able to connect to the masses and hence able to ensure their safety. It is not given here, because here it is closed circuit television cameras, better monitoring, these are given here, but this information is not given here. So option one is not our answer. The city police have been provided with high-tech equipment like speed cameras, this is given information, and installation CCTV monitoring, this is also given information. That's mean second and third will be our answer. So option will be D. This is given here, closed circuit CCTV, closed circuit, as well as high tech equipment like speed cameras. This is also mentioned here, speed cameras. And let's move to question number 10. Paragraph 1. First paragraph, the key findings of study were discussed at the press interaction organized by BIGRS in Mumbai on Thursday afternoon. Which of the following is correct according to the given passage? Which of the correct option? First option, we get pedestrians accounted for over half the fatalities in road accidents on the city streets in 2018. The study further states that the majority of these victims used in the roads to work owing the lack of proper footpath, and men accounted for 85%, women accounted for 15% on the fatalities. So just say that all information are given in paragraph number 1. Your pedestrian accounted for half of the fatalities in road accident, this is the given information, half the fatalities. It is given information. Second, the study further states that the majority of these victims use the road to work owing lack of proper footpath. It's also given me information, lack of proper footpath, and men accounted 85% and 15%. 85% and 15%, it is also given here. So males and females 85 and 15%, it is also given here, but it is in paragraph number 2. It is in paragraph number 2. One thing guys, you have to clear that we can give the answer all of the above. And we also can say that 1 and 2. 1 and 2 means, I mean to say, D. Now, you have to locate that here it is mentioned in paragraph 1. If it is referring paragraph 1, so then our answer will be 1 and 2. But here it is just mentioned paragraph 1. It's not a refer to paragraph 1. So paragraph 1 mentioning here. So we can also take our answer in paragraph number 2 also. So our answer will be all of the above. And if it is referring to paragraph 1, if it is referring to paragraph 1, refer to paragraph 1, According to paragraph 1, if it is mentioned that's a referring, so then our answer will be 1 and 2. But if we take paragraph 1 and 2, so then our answer will be all of the above. But 3 information is given here, and most important, if there is no mentioned in paragraph 1, so our answer will be 1, 2 and 3, means all of the above. So guys, these are the 10 questions of comprehension. I hope it is clear to you. This is not so tough. Language is little bit of easy for you. Just run through, and it is a very common topic also. We all aware about the road accident. We all know that what is the reason of road accident, and we also know that the what is the suggestions and what is the conclusion. What can be the conclusion of the road accident? So this type of comprehension, if you get in your paper, try to attempt this and try to correct these questions, because these are not so tough. It is easy type of questions. It is easy type of paragraph. If you just little bit of give your concentration, and if you improving, if you improve your reading skill and reading ability, so it will be not too tough for you. It will be easy for you, and definitely you try it. You have to score 8 out of 10 marks. Okay, so these are the 10 questions of comprehensions. In our next class, I will bring some different type of questions, different type of 10 questions, and you have to just go practice it and try to improve your English. And till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.